Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss buffer system in detail, which is very very important for the regulation of acid-base balance and for the maintenance of physiological pH of blood, along with the various multiple choice questions asked from this particular topic in various entrance examination. First, we will see the definition of acid, base and buffers. So acid is defined as a substance releases protons or hydrogen ions, and the examples are hydrochloric acid and carbonic acid. So hydrochloric acid gets dissociated into H plus and chloride ion, and H2CO3 gets dissociated into H plus and bicarbonate ion. So that's why they are called as acid, because they releases protons or hydrogen ions. And the base is a substance that accepts protons or hydrogen ions, and the examples are bicarbonate ion and phosphate ion. So this bicarbonate ion, after accepting the proton, it gets converted to the carbonic acid, and HPO4-2, after accepting the H plus, it gets converted to the H2PO4-. So that is regarding the acid and base. Now we will see the definition of buffer. The buffer is a solution of weak acid and its corresponding salt, which resist a change in a pH when small amount of acid or base is added to it. And buffering mechanism, we can convert strong acid or strong base to a weaker one. So that is regarding the definition of buffer. Now, normal pH of the body fluids. So the normal pH of the arterial blood is around 7.4, and the normal pH of venous blood and interstitial fluid is around 7.35. And the pH of blood is maintained within a remarkable constant level of 7.35 to 7.45. So we can say that normal physiological pH of blood is around 7.35 to 7.45. If there is any reduction in the pH below 7.35, then it is termed as acidosis. And if there is any reduction, any increase in the pH greater than 7.45, then it is termed as alkalosis. Now, why maintenance of pH is important? Because activities of almost all enzyme system which is available in the human body are influenced by hydrogen ion concentration or by the pH. And if there is any alteration in the hydrogen ion concentration, then it can alter the functions of all the cell and body, the conformation of the biological structural components, and the uptake and release of oxygen. So that's why maintenance of physiological pH of blood is very very important, because activities of almost all enzyme system in the body are influenced by hydrogen ion concentration or by the pH. Now we will see the examples of metabolic sources of acid which can alter the blood pH, and the first example is of fixed acids or non-volatile acids. The examples are phosphoric acid, sulfuric acid, which are produced from the metabolism of proteins and lipoproteins, pyruvic acid, lactic acid, and keto acids. These are the example of organic acids. And the example of volatile acids, which can breathe out through the lungs. There is one example of volatile acid, carbonic acid. These are the example of metabolic sources of acid which can alter the blood pH. Now, metabolic sources of bases. So, citrate salts of fruit juice may produce bicarbonate salt. Ammonia, which is produced from the deamination of amino acids. And the formation of biphosphate and acetate also contributes to the alkalinizing effect. So these are the example of metabolic sources of bases. Now we will see the regulatory mechanism which is available for the maintenance of normal blood pH. So the first mechanism is the buffer mechanism, which is called as a first line defense. Second mechanism is called as a respiratory mechanism, which is called as a second line of defense. And the third mechanism is the renal mechanism, which is called as a third line of defense. So these are the three regulatory mechanisms which is available for the maintenance of normal physiological blood pH, which is 7.35 to 7.45. And in today's video, we will discuss buffer mechanism in detail. First, what is buffer? So buffer is a substance that can resist the change in a pH even after addition of strong acid or base. And it is a mixture of weak acid and a salt of its conjugate base, and the example is NaHCO3 and carbonic acid. If one molecule differs from another by only a proton, then two are called as a conjugate acid-base pair. Now, buffer can reversibly bind hydrogen ions, and the general form of the buffering reaction is buffer, after binding to the hydrogen ion, it gets converted to the weak acid, and this reaction is the reversible reaction. So whenever there is a high amount of hydrogen ion concentration is available, there is a shift to the right occurs, and whenever there is a low amount of hydrogen ion concentration is available, at that time shift to the left occurs. So that is about the mechanism of buffering reaction. And the buffer systems do not eliminate hydrogen ions from the body or add them to the body. They just hide them until balance can be re-established. So that is about the buffer. Now, buffering capacity of the buffer depends on the concentration of the buffer, relationship between the pKa of the buffer and the desired pH. The pKa is defined as a pH at which buffer exists in equal proportion with its acid and conjugate base. And the maximum buffering capacity is achieved when pH is equal to the pKa. So for the maximum blood buffering, pKa of the buffer should be around 7.4, which is the physiological pH of the blood. That is regarding the factors affecting the buffering capacity of the buffer. First one is the concentration of the buffer, and the second one is the pKa of the buffer. Now, blood buffer. So we will see the example of the blood buffer. So there are two examples. First one is the plasma buffer, or it is called as a extracellular buffer, and the second one is the intracellular buffer or erythrocyte buffer. So first buffer system is the bicarbonate buffer system, and the example of extracellular buffer for the bicarbonate buffer is the NaHCO3 and carbonic acid, and the example of intracellular buffer is KaHCO3 and H2CO3. Second example is the phosphate buffer, and for the extracellular one, example is Na2HPO4 and NaH2PO4, and the example of intracellular buffer is the K2HPO4 and KH2PO4. And example of protein buffer system is sodium protein and hydrogen protein, potassium hemoglobin and hydrogen hemoglobin, and potassium HBO2 and hydrogen HBO2. So that is regarding the various buffer system which is available in the blood. There are two important buffer system, that is extracellular or plasma buffer and erythrocyte or intracellular buffer. Now we will discuss each of this buffer system in detail. The first one is the bicarbonate buffer system. So bicarbonate buffer system is the most important extracellular buffer, but the buffering activity or buffering capacity of this bicarbonate buffer system is relatively low because its pKa value is around 6.3, but it plays an important role in the maintaining blood pH because of its high concentration. That is the first important thing. Second important thing is two elements of the bicarbonate buffer system, that is bicarbonate and carbonic acid, are regulated by the kidneys by the lungs respectively. Now, mechanism of action of bicarbonate buffer. When a strong acid like hydrochloric acid is added to the bicarbonate buffer solution, the increased hydrogen ions are buffered by the bicarbonate ion to form a very weak acid, that is carbonic acid, which in turn forms CO2 and H2O, and this CO2 will be excreted via lung through the air. So this is the mechanism, showing the mechanism of action of bicarbonate buffer when strong acid like HCl is added to the bicarbonate buffer solution. So the increased H plus ion concentration are buffered by the bicarbonate and it gets converted to the weak acid, that is H2CO3, and this H2CO3 is dissociated into carbon dioxide and H2, and this carbon dioxide will be excreted via lung through the air. Now when sodium hydroxide is added to the bicarbonate buffer, so hydroxyl ion from sodium hydroxide combines with the H2CO3 and it will form a weak base, that is NaHCO3 and H2O. So this is the reaction showing the buffering of sodium hydroxide with the help of carbonic acid. So this strong base is converted to the weak base. And any non-volatile acid which is stronger than carbonic acid can be buffered by the bicarbonate. And the plasma bicarbonate is a measure of the base that remains after all the acids which are stronger than carbonic acids have been neutralized, and it is also termed as a alkali reserve of the body because it represents the reserve of the alkali which is available for the neutralization of strong acids, and it has been termed as a alkali reserve. Net physiological pH, that is 7.4, the average normal ratio of the concentration of the bicarbonate ion and the carbonic acid in the plasma is 25 millimole per liter to 1.25 millimole per liter. So we can say that concentration of bicarbonate to the carbonic acid is 20:1 at the normal physiological pH. So if there is any change in the concentration of either bicarbonate or carbonic acid, it will lead to the change in the ratio of carbonate ion and bicarbonate ion and carbonic acid, which gets accompanied by change in the pH. The two elements of the bicarbonate buffer system, that is bicarbonate ion and the carbonic acid, are regulated by increasing or decreasing the rate of reabsorption of bicarbonate by the kidneys, and by altering the rates of removal or retention of carbonic acid by the lungs. Now we will discuss the phosphate buffer system. The phosphate buffer system is not important as a blood buffer, and it plays major role in the buffering renal tubular fluid as well as various intracellular fluids. Mechanism of action of phosphate buffer. When a strong acid like hydrochloric acid is added to the phosphate buffer, the H plus ion is accepted by the base, that is HPO4-2, and it converted to the H2PO4-. So the strong acid hydrochloric acid is converted to the weak acid, that is NaH2PO4. So this hydrochloric acid, which is a strong acid, it gets converted to the weak acid, that is NaH2PO4, with the help of phosphate buffer. And when a strong base like NaOH is added to the phosphate buffer, the OH- is buffered by the H2PO4- and form HPO4-2 and water. Thus the strong base, that is NaOH, is replaced by the weak base, which is HPO4-2. So this strong base, that is NaOH, is replaced by a weak base, which is Na2HPO4, with the help of phosphate buffer. And at the physiological pH, the concentration of the ratio of HPO4-2 H2PO4- is 4:1. And the pKa value of phosphate buffer is around 6.8. And the organic phosphate, which exists in the form of 2,3-BPG, which is present in the erythrocyte, it accounts for around 16% of the non-carbonate buffer of the erythrocyte fluid. So 2,3-BPG accounts for around 16% of the non-carbonate buffer of the erythrocyte fluid. Now we will see the protein buffer. in the blood, plasma proteins and the specially albumin act as a buffer. In acid solution, the amino group which is present in the amino acid picks up the excess H plus ions forming NH3 plus, and in the basic solution, the acidic group which is present in the amino acid, that is COOH group, gives up the hydrogen ions forming the OH minus of alkali to water. So that is the mechanism of protein buffer. And other important buffer groups of protein in the physiological pH change are imidazole group of histidine. So this imidazole group of histidine plays important role in the regulation of physiological pH of blood, because the pKa value of imidazole group of histidine is very near to the physiological pH of blood. And in the albumin, there is a presence of around 16 histidine residues. So that's why albumin play a very, very important role in the regulation of physiological pH of blood. Now, hemoglobin buffer. So hemoglobin buffer is the major intracellular buffer of the blood, which is present in the erythrocytes. Each hemoglobin molecule contains around 38 molecules of histidine in comparison to that of albumin, which contain around 32 molecules of histidine. And the imidazole group of histidine has a pKa value around 7.3, which is very, very near to the physiological pH of blood. That's why this hemoglobin and albumin plays very, very important role in the regulation of physiological pH of blood. It buffers carbonic acid, which is H2CO3. Now, action of hemoglobin buffer. So, hemoglobin works effectively in cooperation with that of bicarbonate system. So, this is the picture showing the mechanism of hemoglobin buffer. So, in the lungs, deoxyhemoglobin, which is carried from the tissue, is oxygenated to oxyhemoglobin. The formation of this oxyhemoglobin from the reduced hemoglobin releases the hydrogen ions. These hydrogen ions are buffered by the bicarbonate ion, and it gets converted to the carbonic acid, and this carbonic acid is converted to the carbon dioxide and H2O, and this carbon dioxide is expired in the air. So that is the first reaction which is occurring inside the lung, the help of hemoglobin. Now, as the concentration of HCO3- in the erythrocyte is dropped because they are used to buffer oxyhemoglobin over here in the lung, so the bicarbonate ion which is present in the plasma will shift to the erythrocyte. So to preserve the electron neutrality, some negative ions must enter the plasma. So this erythrocytes are readily permeable to the chloride ion, so there will be the sifting of chloride from the lungs via blood to the RBC occurs, and which is termed as a chloride sift, which is very, very important for the maintenance of electroneutrality. That is the second reaction. Now the third reaction, which is occurring inside the tissues in the RBCs, that oxygen tension is reduced. Hence, the oxyhemoglobin dissociates, delivering O2 to the cells via Bohr effect. Fine. There will be the delivery of O2 occurs to the tissues via Bohr effect, and there will be the generation of deoxyhemoglobin. Fine. And the CO2, which is synthesized from the tissue metabolism, is hydrated and it gets converted to the carbonic acid, and this carbonic acid is dissociated to the H plus and HCO3 minus, and this H plus ion will get combined to the deoxyhemoglobin, and it gets converted to the H hemoglobin, which is very, very important for the buffering of this H plus ion concentration inside the RBC, and this H hemoglobin will be transferred to the lung via venous blood circulation, where it will be buffered by the bicarbonate ion. And this bicarbonate ion synthesized in the RBC will be transferred via RBC to the lungs with the help of chloride sift. So this is the various steps which is occurring inside the lungs as well as in the RBC by the help of hemoglobin. So this is how this hemoglobin play important role in the regulation of physiological pH of blood in coordination with bicarbonate buffer. The transport of appreciable quantity of the carbon dioxide which is released from the tissues without a change in the pH is called as a isohydric transport of CO2. And the most of the CO2 which is transported in the plasma is in the form of bicarbonate, that is HCO3-. And the because HCO3-, HCO3 or bicarbonate is much more soluble in the blood plasma than carbon dioxide, this indirect route increases the blood capacity to carry CO2 from the tissues to the lungs. Now we will see the various multiple choice question asked from this particular topic. So the first question is, important buffer in the extracellular fluid is, and the options are hemoglobin, bicarbonate, protein and the phosphate. So in the question, it is particularly asked regarding the extracellular fluid. So we know the answer that important buffer in the extracellular fluid is the bicarbonate. Hemoglobin is the example of intracellular. So the answer is B. Second question is, normal pH of plasma is maintained by all of the following except, and the options are plasma buffer, lungs mechanism, heat mechanism and the renal mechanism. The correct answer is, we have already studied that there are three mechanisms which is available for the regulation of pH of blood. First one is the buffer system, second one is the respiratory mechanism and the third one is the renal mechanism. So the answer is C, heat mechanism. Third question is, normal pH of blood is, and the options are 7.0, 7.2, 7.4, 7.6 and the correct answer is 7.4. Another question is, at blood pH 7.4, the ratio of NaHCO3 and carbonic acid will be, and the options are 5:1, 10:1, 20:1 and 4:1. So the ratio of NaHCO3 to the H2CO3 at the physiological pH, that is 7.4, is 20:1, while for the phosphate buffer it is 4:1. Another question is, which of the following is volatile acid? The options are phosphoric acid, carbonic acid, sulfuric acid and lactic acid. So the correct answer is, example of volatile acid is carbonic acid. This was my reference. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe Biochemistry Basics by Dr. Amit. And don't forget to press the bell icon so you can get all the notifications from it.